Dear student, myself Rajendra Asari. I am assistant professor in computer science department at government Bangad PG college Didwana. In the previous lecture we started a lecture series on database and management system. We already covered some basics on relational algebra operation like select operation, project operation, set, intersection, union. Okay, all these basic operation already covered, and based on this we have done various queries. Okay, then we have done some queries on SQL also. In SQL we have basic three clauses like select statement, from statement and where statement. So all these are already covered, and we have discussed about DBMS architecture also. In database architecture there are various levels are there. At the topmost layer, that is called as view level, various users play their different role, like database administrator is there, sophisticated users are there, application programs are there, navy users are there. In the middle layer that is called as logical level or logical schema, and at the bottom there is a physical schema. On physical layer there is a full control of database administrator, right? So all these concept already covered. Now in today's lecture we will be focusing some new concept. So first concept is outer join. It is basically an extension of join operation that avoid loss of information. Now in order to understand outer join, first you need to understand what is meaning of join. So up to this point we have done Cartesian product, natural join. So what actually we were doing in the Cartesian product, we are just multiplying all the possibility or all the tuples of first relation with all the tuples of second relation, means all the possibility we are taking in case of Cartesian product. Now one disadvantage is there in Cartesian product is that there may be redundancy, means some tuples may some tuples or attribute values can be duplicate. So in order to remove the redundancy we switch to natural join. The natural join will automatically remove the duplicacy based on some common attribute, right? Now one more concept comes into picture now is outer join. Sometime what happened that in both the relation, suppose we are doing some joins, so in both the relation common attribute is present, but corresponding to common attribute some values are present in the first row, or we can say first relation, but they are not present in the second relation in other attribute. Suppose I am saying one relation I am having is R. In R there are three attribute A, B and C, and another relation is C and D, is having two attribute C and D. So C is common attribute. Based on this, when we apply some join, then the resultant will be having four attribute A, B, C and D. Now suppose we are picking C, corresponding to C there are A, B value in, we can say in relation R, but corresponding to C there is no D value, D attribute value in the another relation, that is relation S. Then what happen? That particular information will be lost. So in order to avoid this we apply a concept called as outer join. Okay, so it is basically an extension of join operation that avoid loss of information, right? Now computers join and then adds tuple from one relation that does not match tuples in the other relation to the result of the join. That's why it is, so some values are automatically added in the relation of the joined relation in order to avoid the loss of information. That's why it is called as outer join. Outer join means while doing the join we are adding some values from outside. Okay, now in this null values concept comes into picture. It uses null values. Now what do you mean by null value? So null signifies that the value is unknown or does not exist. If a particular value does not exist or that value is unknown to the database, then it is referred as null value. Okay, all comparison involving null values are, roughly speaking, are false by definition. Okay, we shall study precise meaning of comparison with null in the later upcoming lectures, right? One separate lecture is dedicated to the null values in the upcoming lecture, right? Now outer join example is listed here. If you notice, there are two relation. First relation name is lawn. I am picking the marker. First relation name is lawn. In this lawn relation, there are three attributes. First attribute is lawn number, second attribute is branch name, and third attribute is amount. Corresponding to lawn number attribute, there are three possible value in this domain: L170, L230, and L260. These are the lawn number entries. Second is branch name. In branch name, downtown, redwood, and Paris, three entries. In amount, 3000, 4000, and 700. So in this relation lawn, there are three attributes, okay, and three tuples are there. Okay, three tuples means there is one entry corresponding to each attribute in every row. Okay, next relation is borrower. I'm again taking the marker. Relation name is borrower. In this relation, there are two attributes. First attribute is customer name, and second attribute is loan number. If you see, loan number is present in relation loan also. So we can say here loan number is non-key attribute, and which is primary key of some other relation. That's why here loan number is foreign key. Here loan number, if loan number is here in the loan relation is primary key, then definitely that loan number attribute will be foreign key in some other relation. Because according to foreign key definition, the attribute which is primary key in another relation is called as foreign key in the current relation, right? Customer name is having three entries: Jones, Smith, and Hayes. Similarly, loan number is having L170, L230, and L155. Okay, so three rows are there. There are two attributes and three attribute two and three tuple, right? Next, now outer join. So suppose if we want to combine these two rows. So if you see, one common attribute name is loan number. So loan number L170, again it is present in borrower also. L230 present in borrower also, but L260 is not present in the borrower relation. So corresponding to L260, there are Paris and 1700 entries there, but customer name will be not present. So corresponding to that, we have to apply what? Null value from the other relation. That's why it is called as outer join. Okay, now see, join, we are applying the natural join, loan and borrower. Then what happened? The common attribute will be taken only once, that is loan number. If we normally do natural join, then what will happen? Only the common entries will be picked, and the entries which are not present in both the relation will not be picked. So there will be loss of information. Suppose in this case, L260 is not present in both the relation, so L260 will be not taken. If you see, L170 is present in loan relation as well as borrower relation. Okay, L170 corresponding to loan number, L230 is also present. So only these two rows will be picked. Okay, so now see, loan number L170 corresponding branch name downtown, amount 3000, and customer name will be Jones. So this customer name is coming from where? From the borrower relation. Similarly, L230 Redwood branch 4000 amount, and Smith customer name is coming from borrower relation. Now see, if you notice that L260 is not coming. So if you pick L260, it is called as left outer join. Why? Left outer join means the values will be picked from left relation automatically, exact values, but from the right side relation, the null values will be entered, right? So if you see, loan entry from the loan relation, 260 is coming. 260 entry is coming, and corresponding to 260, if you see, L260, Paris, and 1700 will come. But corresponding to that, customer name is not present. So okay, according to the customer name or corresponding to customer name, we will put here null value. So if in the right relation we are putting null value, it is called as left outer join. Left value, left relation value as it is pegged, but second relation value are entered from outside as null value. That's why it is called as left outer join, and the symbol is natural join, and it will be two horizontal line in the left side. These two horizontal line, and this will be natural join. So this is what left outer join. Okay, values or exact value from the left relation pegged, left relation exact value, and in the right relation we will put what? Null value. In the right relation, null value. Next, outer join, right outer join. Second possibility is right outer join. In right outer join, what we will do, if we picked the, suppose second relation is customer name, borrower relation. So if you pick Jones and Smith and Hayes, suppose L155 we are picking, then L260 will be not picked. It means Paris and 1700 entry will not be there. So corresponding to these entry, if we are putting in the left relation null value, it is called as right outer join, because we are taking right relation value, that is borrower relation value. Borrower relation value is, see, loan number, branch name, amount, customer name, all the customer name entry we are taking. It means right relation value, we are taking all the value from the right side. So corresponding the left relation, we are putting what? Null value. So if we are picking all the value from the right side, all values from the right relation, it is called as what? Right outer join. And in the left relation, we will put corresponding value is null value. So that's why it is called as what? Right outer join. Okay. Now next is full outer join. In full outer join, we are combining both the left outer join as well as right outer join. Means corresponding to left relation, if we are putting null value, it is right outer join combination. And corresponding to right relation, if we are putting null value, it is called as left outer join. So combination of both these left outer join and right outer join in combination form is called as what? Full outer join. Okay. Next is null values. It is possible for tuple to have a null value which are denoted by null for some of their attribute. Now null signifies an unknown value, or that a value does not exist. The result of any arithmetic expression involving null is always null. Now aggregate functions simply ignore null values, because in aggregate function there are various input and only one output is there. So they can ignore the null value input. For duplicate elimination and grouping, null is treated like any other value, and two nulls are assumed to be the same in case of SQL. No matter it is put in which attribute, corresponding to which attribute, all the two null or more than two nulls will be assumed the same, because null value doesn't have any actual value. Now some null value examples are listed here. If we do comparison with null value, then it returns the special truth value, which is unknown. If false was used instead of unknown, then not of a less than 5. A less than 5, suppose I am writing, and not of this would not be equivalent to a greater than or equal to 5. If unknown is there with this condition, right? Now three valued logic using the truth value unknown. Or if we are applying, if we do true or with the unknown, definitely it will give the true, because one is true in case of or. Unknown or false, it means the result will depend on the second value, that is unknown. Unknown or unknown, definitely it will be unknown. Similarly, second three value logic is AND. If you do true and unknown, result will be unknown, because if one is true, then result is depending on the unknown in case of AND. If one is false, definitely answer is false, no matter the second is unknown, false or true. Unknown and unknown, definitely unknown. Not, if we do unknown not, then definitely again it will be unknown, because we don't know the value, then exact value, then unknown not value will of unknown will be also be unknown, right? In SQL, P is unknown evaluates to true if predicate P evaluate to unknown, right? Result of select predicate is treated as false if it evaluate to unknown. Very, very important this point. Means P is unknown, evaluate to true. If predicate P evaluate to unknown. And second is result of select predicate is treated as false if evaluate to unknown. Now next concept is modification of the database. We can modify the database means we can delete some tuples which are not required. We can insert some new tuples and we can update or change the values corresponding to any tuple or any attribute. We can delete a particular attribute also, particular tuple also. We can insert some new attributes or we can insert some new records or tuples. We can update the name of a particular attribute, domain values of a corresponding attribute. Okay, so these all things come under modification of the database. The content of database may be modified either using deletion, insertion or addition. All these operations are expressed using the assignment operator. Means in the left right side we are doing the operation and the final result is going into the left side. Okay, with the left arrow. So assignment operator already we covered. The task or the duty of the assignment operator is just to put the right side calculation expression into a left side. Okay, so all these concept will be covered in the upcoming lecture. Modification will be done in detail with suitable queries in SQL. Thank you.